So in this video today, okay, we're adding sockets in an installation. Now, the current socket you can see here, okay, is currently behind a bed, and the customer wants a double socket either side of the bed behind the dressing tables, okay, or the side tables. Now, as you can see here, it's actually wired in a ring, okay? So we've got two lines, two neutrals and two CPCs. It could be a radial, but it's actually a ring final circuit. What we have to look at, okay, is if we look at in the on-site guide, we could spur off of this ring final circuit. Now, when we look at that, okay, we're actually on a ring final circuit, we're actually only allowed one spur per existing outlet. So the problem here I have is I actually have two outlets to put in off of an existing one. So what I would potentially need to do, okay, is if we're going to have more than one spur off of an existing outlet on a ring final circuit, we would have to put in maybe a fused connection unit, okay? And then once we put in a fused connection unit, we can actually have as many sockets as we like from that ring final circuit on the spur, because it's protected now by the 13 amp fuse within the fuse connection unit. However, what I'm gonna do today is slightly different, because this socket doesn't need to be accessed and I don't really wanna put a fuse connection unit behind the bed where, let's say the fuse does blow, they have to pull the bed out, okay? What I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna look at extending the ring final circuit. So what I've done is I've already started prepping it. It's a dot and dab wall. So I've cut the hole over there for the first socket outlet, and what I've managed to do, the dab was just by this socket, so I managed to drill through there, okay, with sort of a 16 mil bit, and then we're going to feed the rods through, okay. Hopefully we can get through to that socket without having to chop any of this wall out. It'll look nicer for the customer, saves on paying for it to be made good, and then we're going to pull the cables in. So all I'm going to do first, okay, is just try and get my rods in. I'm going to try and angle them up so that when they slightly drop down, hopefully it'll be in line with the socket outlet. And then if you can see that over there, if I just bring this to this socket outlet, we've managed to fish it through. Okay, so what I'm gonna do now is I'm actually gonna fix a back box in there, pull the cables in, get everything grommeted up, and then we'll look at the other side. Hopefully we can be lucky enough to have no dab in between the socket outlet over there and the existing one. We might be able to do the same thing. So I've got the cables taped in the other end, okay? I just wanted to show you as we pull them through. Just a bit, let's just get rid of this rod. As we pull them through, like so. You'll notice that actually what I've done when taping them, okay, if I bring it in close, what I've done when taping them, rather than tape them all onto the rod themselves or both cables, because I'll explain why we're running two cables, because we're extending the ring. I've taped one here and I've taped the other cable together with the next cable. So that actually when they're trying to come through the hole in the back box over there, you're not trying to get a bigger diameter because it probably wouldn't have fitted. So we've just tied this to there and that to there. So as you can see now, we've got this socket in to the left. We managed to fish through without there being too much dot and dab. So that went quite well. It means we didn't have to do any chasing really. So the customer's happy, one on the other side as well. Now, we talked about we could put a switch here or a fuse connection unit, okay? But we decided not to do that because it will be behind the bed if the fuse ever blows, etc. It's just, it's harder for the customer to then have to pull the bed out. It's quite a big heavy bed to replace it. So what we've decided to do instead, because this socket isn't needed again, is we're gonna extend the ring, okay? Now we're just gonna look at the original legs, which are here. So we have two legs coming up, okay? And what we've done is we've actually extended both legs. So what we've done is we've taken one cable to the socket to the right-hand side, okay? And then these will connect to that. So at the minute, the ring is coming up here, round to that socket. We've then run a cable from the right-hand socket all the way through to this socket on the left-hand side. So at the minute, the ring comes up, it connects between these and these, goes off to the right-hand side, comes all the way back to the left-hand side. Then we've run another cable from this left-hand side all the way back here to here, and then this will connect onto the other leg of the ring. Remember, if we have, we can only have one spur, okay, one unfused spur, as per the on-site guide, per outlet on the ring or per accessory, okay? However, if we want more than one, we can either put in a fuse connection unit, which means we can have as many after that fuse connection unit as we possibly want to,
because it has a 13 amp plug top fuse in it. But what we've decided to do today is actually keep the ring in place and not have to put in a fuse connection unit. So it comes up here, round to the right hand side, all the way to the left hand side, back, and then through this leg to continue onto the ring. Okay, and then we'll do our relevant testing that's needed and produce the relevant certification.